Guys, we've been waiting for this movie forever. Will this be the film that finally breaks the curse? Let's find out. Warcraft is directed by Duncan Jones and it is based on the commercially successful series World of Warcraft, a series that I've never got involved with. I think I played 5 minutes of it when I was like in fifth grade and then I stopped because it just wasn't my cup of tea. If you guys don't know what this movie's about, there's two races, the orcs and the humans. There's a portal that comes in. Sometimes the orcs come in, take the humans in order for the orc lord to take away their souls and add more power. It's something like that. And he even does that to some of the orcs. And then some crazy stuff happens. It's really not easy for me to explain the plot of this movie. And I wish I could explain it correctly, but at the same time, this movie's kind of all over the place. So I'm just gonna say this, it's just orcs versus humans. And yeah, we have our movie. Duncan Jones is the director of this film. I love that guy. Moon and Source Code. If you guys have not seen either one of those films, you are doing yourself some disservice by not watching those films because there are two really underrated films. Moon especially. Moon is a very underappreciated indie with Sam Rockwell. And then Source Code is a very underrated blockbuster with Jake Gyllenhaal. So if you guys have not seen any of those two films, please check them out because they're really well-directed films. So that's kind of why I was really excited for Warcraft. And also, it didn't really look like that bad of a movie. It looked like it was going to be something really, really cool. And there are a lot of cool moments to it. But overall, this movie is getting bashed. Like, bashed by critics. And I'm not one of those people that's going to bash it. Because I didn't hate the movie. But I didn't like it as much as I wanted to. But let's start with the positives. Visually, the film is amazing. Visually appealing as hell. And the cinematography is also really gorgeous. Technically, the film is very well done. The motion capture on the orcs, A+. Like, grade A for that motion capture. Really excellent motion capture. Particularly with Toby Kebbell's character. I'll get to the acting later on and towards the end of this review. But for now, the visuals and the cinematography, all great. Action sequences, for the most part, are really well done. I was really enthralled by the sequences. I was into them. I didn't know what was going to happen. When the orcs and the humans got hit, I felt like I was being hit. And it was really cool and stuff. And it felt like Lord of the Rings, Game of Thrones type of battle. So that was pretty cool. And I think that's what I expected going into this movie. So let's get to my problems. The story is all over the place. I think that's one of the main criticisms with this film. It is a jumbled storyline, which is upsetting because, like I said, Duncan Jones is a great director. In his last two movies, they had cohesive storylines. They weren't all over the place, but this one is kind of all over the place. The editing, though. This movie's really, really slow. I was kind of bored during some moments of the film, but some parts I was like, yes, I like what I'm seeing. But some parts I was just like, alright, can we speed this up just a bit? But you could have tried your best to cut out the stuff that wasn't necessary in this film and add the stuff that was necessary, because it definitely looked like there were some sequences that were cut out that should have been in the film. But what about the acting, Brian? How good is the acting? Well, I love all the orcs. Toby Kebbell in particular, his character is the most interesting one in the film. He's one that wants to go against his ward because of what he's doing. And he has a really compelling story. And like I said, the motion capture on him is great. The humans, though, I didn't really care that much about them. It's not that I didn't care about their characters. It's just their performances just were all eh to me. The main guy, Travis Fumel, I think that's his name. His character kind of reminded me of Charlie Hunnam from Pacific Rim, where he has a cool job, he loves doing what he does, but his performance is just kind of stoic. It just really has no emotion to it. Ben Foster, I thought, was horrible in this film. He plays this wizard who was very over the top. He was like, he was trying to talk like Apocalypse, you know, Oscar Isaac's Apocalypse, and it just did not work, especially towards the last act of the film. Oh my god, ew. That goes for like Razzie type of material. And Paul Patton's in this movie. She plays a half orc, half human. I love Paul Patton. I think she gets bashed way too much. The only serviceable movie that she was in was Ghost Protocol. And sadly, she's not really good in this film either. She's kind of over the top in this too. But again, it's not her character that I disliked. It's really more the performance, because it was kind of like a hammy performance. It was like, oh, feel for me, like, please. But like I said, this wasn't a terrible film. It shouldn't get the huge negative reception that it's been getting. But I understand the disappointment towards the film. I was disappointed with it. But overall, I did not hate Warcraft. There were a lot of the inside lights, but also there were some cliffhangers too. Like, I don't know if I want a sequel to this. I kind of want to see where the story's going to go. But then again, the way it was executing this movie, I don't know if I could see any more with the story. So I'm going to give the movie a solid C. guys, tell me down what you thought of Warcraft if you saw it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys soon.